back to my channel. In this video, I will discuss with you why leaves turn yellow on tomatoes, peppers, and cucumbers. What are the causes, and how can we solve it? Which method can we use to fix leaves that have yellowed due to iron deficiency? I will explain these. One of the reasons for yellowing is insufficient lighting. For example, the upper leaves of the cucumber you see here are not getting sunlight. Because of this, there is a slight curling. However, the lower leaves are getting plenty of sunlight, so it can gather all its energy from here. The cucumber seedling. Here is an upside-down planted cucumber seedling. That's why the leaves below are getting plenty of sunlight. But on the contrary, if we consider a cucumber seedling that grows from the bottom up and has lush leaves, one of the reasons the leaves at the very bottom, which remain within the thick cucumber bushes, start to yellow is the insufficient amount of light. If cucumber seedlings are planted too close to each other, as the plant grows over time, sunlight cannot penetrate every point. Thus, they turn yellow. Weak. Lighting. Shadows, the sunlight, because a healthy cucumber has thick leaves. That's why the leaves turn yellow and fall off. Look here, it receives direct sunlight, and all the leaves are lush green. What you see at the tips is not any disease. Because when this seedling was small, it got a bit torn by the wind. The tips, that's the reason. The yellowing of the leaves, due to the reasons I mentioned, does not harm the cucumber culture. It also does not affect the harvest. Check from time to time and remove the yellow and dry leaves. Another reason is incorrect watering. Cucumbers love moisture. However, too much moisture affects them as badly as drought. In temperate climates, cucumber bushes need to be watered at least 3 times a week during the summer months. In dry and hot weather, watering should be done daily. Incorrect watering can cause the cucumber fruit to start yellowing and falling off. During watering, the water needs to reach the deepest cucumber roots. If there is a lack of moisture at the bottom of the soil, they start searching on the soil surface to reach that moisture. The roots begin to rise to the surface of the soil and dry out. The same applies to tomatoes. As you can see here, if you see roots on the surface of the soil in a pot or in the ground, try to cover them with soil. The plants search for water causes the leaves and products to yellow. Yellow leaves may appear after prolonged rainy weather. Excessive moisture causes the roots to rot, and as a result, yellowing is again seen in the leaves. When watering, make sure you see water flowing from the pot's drainage. Follow the watering rules. Cucumbers like regular and abundant watering. Aerate the soil to keep it moist. It will retain moisture in the soil for a long time. If necessary, spread dry grass or natural raffia on the soil of the pot. I had shown this process in my previous videos as well. You can do it this way. The seedling in the example photo was a tomato seedling. Watering should not be excessive for tomatoes either. However, it should be sufficient. Firstly, when there is a lack of moisture, the leaves simply dry out. Secondly, the absorption of nutrients in dry soil is much worse. The deficiency of nitrogen and phosphorus in the leaves causes yellowing. As you can see here, the lower leaves have already yellowed and fall off when I hold them. This is not a problem. It will now want to give all its energy to the fruits above. This is quite natural. By the way, let me not skip mentioning the watering of the pepper. Let me say that too. Pepper is a vegetable that is 90% water. It needs abundant and frequent watering. Regardless of the climate in your area, do not allow the soil to dry out. Watering in small amounts causes the fruit to become sluggish, the seedling to yellow, and both the leaves and the product to fall. All right, pepper loves water. However, excessive watering of the soil leads to the development of harmful bacteria that cause root rot. Therefore, make sure there is a drainage hole. If there is no hole for water to drain in your pot, it means there is a problem. Another reason is fungal disease. The yellowing of leaves is caused by common diseases. Fungal disease firstly, leaves rust spots on the upper parts, then dry spots on the leaves. All the leaves dry up and fall off very quickly, and the entire plant becomes weak and lifeless. The seedling you see here does not have such a problem. But if the image in this photo is present, it is a problem. Most of the time, fungal diseases appear after sudden changes in temperature. For example, the daytime temperature exceeded 30 degrees. See? And at night, it dropped to 12 to 15 degrees. Or, during the summer heat, a long cold rain suddenly came. These are the reasons for the formation of fungi. In hot weather altered by cooling and rain, fungi can spread. For powdery mildew problems seen in tomatoes, cucumbers, zucchini, apples, and vineyards, adjust the mixture ratio to 1 cup of milk from the store and 9 cups of water. Apply by spraying onto the leaves. Ensure that the leaves are thoroughly wet. It has been observed to be as effective as synthetic chemicals on these plants. Apply this mixture every 10 days. Another reason for yellowing is spider mites and whiteflies. They love cucumber juice a lot. All the leaves on the cucumber turn yellow and dry out. The only way to prevent it is the elimination of pests. You will either use a pesticide or the natural mixture I prepared, which is linked above. Another reason is fertilization. Rarely, the leaves on the cucumber turn yellow due to nutrient deficiency. This is not only valid for cucumbers, but also for peppers, tomatoes, and other plants. In such cases, it is necessary to find out which elements the plant is lacking. You can determine this based on the condition of the leaves. Here, we apply a very simple method to address iron deficiency in plants. We fill a container with rusty wire, nails, and iron. And we will fill it with water. We will wait for a day or two. Rust water will form. We will use that water. In the meantime, how will we understand which element the plant needs? If only the edges of the greens dry out, it means there is a need for magnesium and potassium. If there are dark green lines on yellow leaves, there is a need for manganese and iron. Right now, we are doing that. Usually, yellowing occurs mostly due to the need for iron. You can apply this simple mixture to most of your plants. You can apply it, and besides the leaves of plants, the yellowing of the leaves of seedlings like tomatoes, peppers, cucumbers is also due to aging. At the end of the season, the leaves naturally turn yellow. Unfortunately, this is a natural process. Yellow leaves appear at the end of the cucumber season when most of the harvest has been collected and the plant begins to age and develop coarse foliage. As I said, after waiting for 2 to 3 days, the water becomes thoroughly brown and the rust mixes into the water. Already... Now we will take this water, over approximately 2 cups of rusty water. We will add about 0.5 liter of normal sugar water to dilute it a bit. You can see, very simple examples here. There are 3 pepper seedlings. This pepper seedling is planted in soil that is only fertilized. If you notice, one of the leaves at the bottom is slightly yellow. The reason for this is again due to its need for iron. The bottom leaf turns slightly yellow. I used worm compost for this seedling. It doesn't need anything. It's quite healthy. But there is such yellowing because there is no drainage hole in the pot. And also due to its iron need, I will apply rusty water to this pepper seedling. We don't pour too much. Pouring a small amount will be sufficient. Over time, these yellow leaves will start to turn dark green. You might have seen it in my previous videos. I had a rose sapling. I pruned its roses after they bloomed. These are its new shoots. But if you notice, the leaves are yellow. Thinking it also needs iron, I will apply the same mixture to it. As I mentioned earlier, you can use it on most of your plants. That's why I'm showing the plants I use it on. Look, this is my strawberry. I sometimes wash the strawberry because I wash it. Look, these leaves turned out like this. And I explained this in the comments. Definitely do not overwater from the top. Try to water mostly from the bottom tray of the pot. Look, it's blooming. It's strawberries. The flowers have already bloomed. It also has strawberries. Here, I will directly apply this rusty water to the strawberries pot tray. I want it to absorb from the bottom. Here, I also have small watermelon seedlings from watermelon seeds, and I planted them in the dragon fruit's pot. I apply this in the same way to the dragon fruit. Look, this one also has slight yellowing. I will publish all the results of these on my Instagram account. Follow from there. I already published the results of most of the videos I shoot on my Instagram page. If you like this video, don't forget to click like and subscribe to my channel and activate the bell to watch my next videos.